Hello friends, this is Dr. Shashikant Bagade with the learning episode of B.Pharm third semester. We'll discuss the topic from the syllabus of Pharmaceutical Chemistry 4, that is Chemistry of Natural Products. This topic deals with alkaloids. In this, we'll discuss the introduction of general methods for determining structure of alkaloids, classification of alkaloids with acquaintance with structure. We'll also discuss structure elucidation of ephedrine, nicotine, xanthine or xanthine derivatives like caffeine, theobromine and theophylline. Let's have a look at what we are going to learn today. This lecture is divided into three modules, including module 1, introduction to general methods of determination of alkaloids or structure of alkaloids, module 2, classification of alkaloids with an acquaintance with structure, module 3, structure elucidation of ephedrine, nicotine, xanthine or xanthine derivatives like caffeine, theobromine and theophylline. Let's start with the module 1. Here, the module 1 is introduction to general methods of determination of structure of alkaloids. To start with this, we must understand alkaloids. Alkaloid means alkali-like. The pharmacist W. Messer proposed the term alkaloid in 1819. According to him, alkaloid means alkali is base and oid means like, are the basic nitrogenous substances of plant origin which have complex molecular structure and many pharmacological activities. As per Lindenberg, alkaloids are defined as natural plant compounds that have a basic character and contains at least one nitrogen atom in a heterocyclic ring and having biological activities. Alkaloids are a large group of secondary metabolites of plant, microbial or animal origin. Most of the alkaloids are optically active and processing nitrogen heterocycle as their structural units with physiological action. Alkaloids are chemically varied mixture of natural substances and composes basic nitrogen containing organic compounds. The alkaloids have different structure and show an extraordinary spectrum of pharmacological activities. Because of these characters, they are important for chemical, physiological studies and taxonomical studies. Properties of alkaloids. Alkaloids are basic in nature and form water-soluble salt with mineral acids. In fact, one or more nitrogen atoms that are present in an alkaloid typically as primary, secondary or tertiary amines contribute to the basicity of alkaloids. The degree of basicity varies considerably depending on the structure of molecule and the presence and location of the functional groups. Most alkaloids are crystalline solid and are bitter in taste. Let's move towards module 2. This module 2 shows classification of alkaloids with an acquaintance with structure. Alkaloids are generally classified according to their amino acid that provides both the nitrogen atom and the fundamental alkaloidal skeleton. However, alkaloids can also be grouped together on the basis of their genetic structure or similarities. The chemotaxonomic classification of some alkaloids are mentioned in the literature which is given. Majority of the alkaloids have been divided into two parts, viz. Non-heterocyclic nucleus and with heterocyclic nucleus. Let's have a look at these two classes of alkaloids. Number one is non-heterocyclic alkaloids. The example of such alkaloids having non-heterocyclic nucleus includes phenylethyl amine, which is shown in the table on your screen. Heterocyclic alkaloid, a large number of specific alkaloid possessing heterocyclic nucleus, for example, pyrrolidine alkaloids, hygrine, then piperidine alkaloid, which is lobeline, then pyrazolidine alkaloid, which is cinnosonin, then tropane alkaloid, which is atropine, then quinoline alkaloid, which is quinine, then isoquinoline alkaloid, which is morphine, then apomorphine alkaloid, which is boldiline, then aldenine alkaloid, including ergometrine, imidazole alkaloid, example pilocarpine, diazoxide alkaloid, example lupinine, then pyrrole alkaloid, example is caffeine, steroidal alkaloid having solanidine, amino alkaloids having ephedrine, then diterpene alkaloids having aconitine. You can see some of the examples of alkaloid in the table on your screen. Second is the biosynthetic classification of these alkaloids. It is based on the name of precursor of alkaloid in biogenetic pathways. There are same precursor for different alkaloids having variation in their taxonomy and pharmacological effects. For example, indole alkaloids derived from tryptophan, piperidine alkaloids derived from lysine, pyrrolidine alkaloids derived from ornithine, phenylethylamine alkaloids derived from tyrosine, imidazole alkaloids derived from histidine. Third part is pharmacological classification. The alkaloids exhibit a broad range of very specific pharmacological characteristics such as analgesic, cardiovascular drugs, CNS stimulants and depressants, dilation of pupil of eye, mydriatics, anticholinergics, sympathomimetics, antimalarial and purgatives. Example includes morphine as narcotic analgesic, quinine as antimalarial, strychnine as reflex excitability, then lobelin as respiratory stimulant, then boldine as cholinergic and laxative, aconitine as neuralgia, pilocarpine as anti-glaucoma agent and myotic, ergonovine as oxytocin, ephedrine as bronchodilator, narcine and analgesic, narcotic and anti-tissue agent. Fourth, taxonomic classification. This particular classification essentially deals with the taxon, that is the taxonomic category. The most common taxa are the genus, subgenus, species, subspecies and variety. For example, cannabinaceous alkaloids, example is cannabis sativa, which is hemp or marijuana. Then rabaceous alkaloid, example is cinchona, containing quinine. Then solanaceous alkaloid, example is atropa belladonna, withania somnifera, which is ashwagandha. Let's move towards module 3, which deals with the structural elucidation of ephedrine, nicotine and xanthine derivatives like caffeine, theobromine and theophylline. The structure elucidation is adopted to know the chemical structure of alkaloids. Also, there are various chemical tests for primary determination of alkaloids as given in the table on your screen. This table shows name of reagents, its composition and results of test, which includes the reagents like Mayer's reagent, then Wagner's reagent, tannic acid, Hager's reagent and Dragontrop's reagent. In case of caffeine and other purine derivatives, can be detected by Murexide test, in which the alkaloids are mixed with a tiny amount of potassium chlorate and a drop of hydrochloric acid and evaporated to dryness, and it gives the resulting residue which is exposed to ammonia vapor. The purine alkaloid produces pink color in this test. However, structural elucidation of ephedrine, nicotine and xanthine derivatives like caffeine, theobromine and theophylline can be achieved by structural elucidation steps and procedures. To know the chemical form, functional group, please see the chemical structure of ephedrine, nicotine and xanthine derivative like caffeine, theobromine and theophylline on your screen. Now let's move towards the general outline for structural elucidation of alkaloid, including some tests or procedures. Let's discuss these tests or procedures. Test 1, which is molecular formula determination. The first step in structural elucidation is the determination of molecular formula and optical rotatory power. Elemental composition and hence the empirical formula is found by combustion analysis. The second test is hydrolysis. Simple fragmentation by hydrolysis with water, acid or alkali yields simple fragments which are then checked. For example, atropine on hydrolysis yields tropane and tropic acid. Test 3, for determination of unsaturation. The unsaturation can be determined by adding bromine water, halogen acid or hydroxylation with KMnO4 or by reducing using either lithium aluminum hydrate or sodium borohydrate. The test 4 is about functional group determination. By using usual standard chemical test or by infrared spectroscopy, the functional nature of alkaloid is determined. For functional nature of oxygen, the oxygen atom may be present in the form of alcoholic hydroxyl group, including aldehyde group, ketonic group and methylene dioxide group, phenolic hydroxyl group, methoxyl group, acetoxyl group, benzoyl oxide group, then carboxyl group. These characterization of groups is given as, for phenolic hydroxyl group, it is identified by soluble in alkali and precipitated by CO2, violet coloration with neutral ferric chloride yields ester on acetylation. This reaction can be used to determine the number of phenolic hydroxyl group, yields ether on reaction with alkyl halide. Test 6, for alcoholic hydroxyl group, it yields ester on acetylation and benzoylation, but which is negative answer for phenolic. This confirmed by oxidation, dehydration and dehydrogenation and by spectroscopy, which is IR and NMR. Alcohols are of three different types, that is primary, secondary and tertiary, and they are usually distinguished by their oxidation products. The number of hydroxyl groups present in the compound is determined by acetylation method. Here, Zervientop's active hydrogen determination method is widely used. When alcohol is heated with methyl magnesium iodide, methane is obtained. By measuring the methane so formed, the amount of alcohol can be determined. Test 7, for carbonyl group or functional group, the presence of aldehyde and ketone is detected by their reaction with hydroxylamine, semicarbazide and phenylhydrazine to form the corresponding oxime, semicarbazone and phenylhydrazone respectively. The aldehyde and ketones are distinguished by their oxidation or reduction products. The carbonyl group of aldehydes, ketones and carboxyl are further confirmed by their spectral data, such as IR, ultraviolet and NMR spectroscopy. The test 8, carboxyl group, which is COOH, the presence of carboxyl group is determined by the following method. The method says its solubility in weak base such as ammonia, ammonium bicarbonate and sodium bicarbonate, esterification with alcohols, then specific IR and NMR signals, then quantitatively by acid alkali titrations performed by titrating the carboxylic acid with NaOH using phenolphthalein as an indicator. By knowing the volume of NaOH consumed, the number of hydroxyl group or carboxyl group are determined. Test 8, ester group, RCOOR. Esters and related groups like amides and lactones are detected by their reaction with water, dilute acid or alkali to the hydroxyl and acidic compounds. By elucidating the acid and alcohol, the nature of alkaloid is determined. Test 9, alkoxy group, which is dash OR group, determined by Zeil's method. Alkoxy group such as methoxy on reaction with hydroboric acid or hydroiodic acid followed by silver nitrate yields equal amount of silver iodide. From the amount of silver iodide formed, the number of alkoxy group is calculated. The estimation of C methyl group. In this, by estimating the acetic acid form upon oxidation, the C methyl group are quantified. The secondary and tertiary amines are distinguished as follows. Here in this test, the secondary amines, which is acylated or benzylated, undergoes Lieberman nitroso reaction, and secondary amines take up to 2 moles of alkyl halide to form quaternary ammonium salts. The tertiary amines take up to 1 mole of alkyl halide to form quaternary ammonium salt. The degradation of alkaloid, this is one of the segment of test. Degradation of alkaloid gives rise to some identifiable products of known structure, and hence by knowing structure of the degradation product, the changes occur during the degradation, it is convenient to know the structure of the original molecule. The different degradation reaction carried out in elucidating the structure of alkaloid includes reductive degradation, then oxidation degradation, zinc distillation, alkali fusion, and dehydrogenation, and many more. Physical methods in conjugation with chemical methods. The development in spectroscopic method helps in determination of molecular structure of complex alkaloids. Morphine structure was established after the development of some methods. The important physical methods used in structural elucidation of alkaloids are IR spectroscopy, UV spectroscopy, NMR spectroscopy, mass spectroscopy, X-ray diffraction analysis, optical rotary dispersion, which is ORD, and circular dichroism, which is CD, then conformational analysis. In IR spectroscopy, the method is used to identify presence of functional group such as hydroxyl, amino, amine, and carbonyl. In case of NMR spectroscopy, the method helps to detect proton of alkyl, then alkynyl, N-methyl, O-methyl, C-methyl, aryl, heteroaryl groups. In case of UV spectrophotometric methods, the UV spectrum of a compound is characteristics of chromophore system and not the whole compound. The mass spectrometry, this method is used to confirm the proposed molecular structure of alkaloid by determining molecular weight of compounds and the fragments of degradation products. The X-ray diffraction analysis, this method is used to distinguish the various possible structures of alkaloids. Here the ORD and CD, that is circular dichroism, this method is used to confirm the structure of optically active stereoisomers. Conformational analysis, it is an experimental technique used to establish the stereochemistry as well as physical properties and chemical reactivity of alkaloids. Dear friends, up till now you have gained a fair idea about general methods of determining structure of alkaloids. We also discussed classification of alkaloids with an acquaintance with the structure. If you miss any of the molecule or if you miss any of the module or content, you may cross check through given references and other web links so that you can stay updated with these topics. The conclusion part. Here we have seen introduction to general methods of determination of alkaloids, then classification, various ways of classification of alkaloids with an acquaintance with structure or chemical properties. The structure elucidation part was also discussed. Alkaloids are basic in nature and form water soluble salt with mineral acids. In fact, one or more nitrogen atoms that are present in an alkaloid, typically as primary, secondary or tertiary amines, contribute to the basicity of alkaloids. The degree of basicity varies considerably depending on the structure of molecule and the presence and location of the functional groups. Most alkaloids are crystalline solid and are bitter in taste. All the alkaloids are very important for physiological function or function of plant and animals. Friends, it's time for all of you to do some self-study. This is Dr. Shashikant Bagade. I'll be back with a new topic. If you want to learn more, you may log on to our website for MCQs, quizzes, LORs at www.cec.nic.in. Till then, keep studying. Wish you all the best.